Hello and welcome to my channel. I am going to do Excel Module 5, SAM Project 1A. Nair Boni Suits, generating reports from multiple workbooks. Basically, this is the fifth module of Excel section of this course. I will do this assignment step by step, and you can get your assignment done by watching this complete video. If you want me to do this assignment for you, or if you want me to do this complete course for you, including all the Excel, Word, Access, PowerPoint, or Outlook assignments, you can contact me and you can hire me for your complete course. My WhatsApp number and email is showing at the bottom of the screen. You can contact me either through WhatsApp or email. You can also hire me for your other courses like accounting, management, finance, information technology, computer sciences, all other writing assignments, mathematics, statistics, etc. So let's start this assignment and solve this assignment step by step. Getting started with the assignment, we are supposed to download this Excel workbook NPEX19-5A first name last name Excel workbook. So I have already downloaded this Excel workbook. And this is the Excel workbook that we are going to use to get this assignment done. We will apply all the steps, all the instructions to this Excel workbook, and we will solve this Excel workbook and we will submit this Excel workbook for the grading. So you can download this from your Cengage or school login. Main part of the assignment is project steps. And total steps to solve in this assignment are 16. We are supposed to solve 16 steps to get this assignment done or to complete this assignment. So Edra Kinsman is the sales manager for Nairborne Suits hotel chain, which has location in Washington, Oregon, Idaho, and Montana. Edra is using multiple worksheets to summarize sales data by state. Break the external link in the worksheet so that the formula in the range B4 up to B7 of the manager information sheet worksheet are replaced with static values. Then switch to the manager information worksheet. So first we are supposed to break the external link in the worksheet. So we are supposed to break the links in the manager information worksheet. So we will go to the manager information worksheet and we will click on the data. So in the queries and connection, click on the workbook links. So we are supposed to break this link. So we will click this dotted line and click break links. There are no links to any external workbook. So that is, you can see there are no links now. So that is all about step number one. Now then switch to the manager information worksheet. So we are done with this one. So let's move to step number two now. So in step number two, it is saying that in cell C5, remove the hyperlink, leaving the unlinked text Bozeman empty in the cell. So cell C5, this has the hyperlink and we are supposed to remove this hyperlink from here. So right click on it and click remove hyperlink. So hyperlink will be removed, and you can see that the Bozeman empty text is there now. So that is all about step number 2, where we were supposed to remove the hyperlink from the cell C5 of the manager information worksheet. So we are done with this step as well, and now we're going to do next step, that is step number 3. So I am doing this step by step for you so that you can solve this assignment on your own. But if you want me to do this for you, I can do this for you as well. So let's do step number 3. Step number 3 is in cell D7, create a hyperlink to an email address as follows. Link to email address Washington. So we will go to cell D7 and we are supposed to insert our email address link to the email address Washington mgr@example.com. Email address is this one. Then display Washington mgr@example.com as the text to display. Text to display will be this one. Then use email the statewide manager for the Washington as the screen tip text. Screen text tip will be this one. Click OK and press OK. You can see that we have inserted the link to the cell D7 according to the requirements given in cell in step 3. So we are done with step 3 as well. So now we're going to do next step, that is step number 4. And step number 4 is saying that in cell B9, create a hyperlink to Nerboni Suits location listing as follows. So cell B9 is here, and we are supposed to insert a hyperlink here. Again, we will click insert link. Link to the file sport ex195 location.docs. We are supposed to link to this one. Then we are supposed to display this as a text and this as a screen tip. We will select our file, that is sport ex195 locations. This one, name of the document. Then we are supposed to show this as a text to display. Text to display will be this one, and then screen tip is also given, that is view the current list of nearby locations. So we are supposed to add this as a screen tip. Click OK. You already have a file name. Okay, yes. So we have added the hyperlink to cell B9. So that is all about step number 4. So we are done with 4 steps of the assignment, and now we are going to do next step, that is step number 5. So added the hyperlink in cell B10 as follows. Use Nerboni Suits website as a display text. Use view the public facing website for Nerboni Suits as a screen tip. Okay, So we are supposed to edit this hyperlink. So we can edit the hyperlink. And we are supposed to use this as the text to display. Text to display should be this one. And this should be the screen tip. This should be the screen tip. And click OK. So you can see that now the text to display has been changed in cell B10. So we have added the hyperlink as required in step number 5. So we have completed 5 steps of the assignment so far. And now we're going to do next step, that is step number 6. So in step number 6, it is saying that Edra wants to apply consistent formatting to the workbook submitted by each of the statewide managers. Group the Idaho, Montana, and Oregon worksheet together and then make the following formatting updates. So we are supposed to make these changes. So it is saying that group the Idaho, Montana, and Oregon worksheet. So we are supposed to group this one. So select this one, press shift, then and select this one. So these 3 worksheets have been grouped as required in step number 6. Now we are supposed to change the font size in the my cell A1 up to F1 to 18 points. So we will first select this range and we are supposed to change the font size to the 18 points. So I have changed the font size to the 18 points that is required in part A. Now we are going to do next part, that is part B. Apply the 20% accent 6 cell style to the my cell A2 up to F2. So first we will select this range, then we are supposed to apply the 20% accent 6 cell style. So let me select this one. So we are supposed to apply the 20% accent 6 cell style. So go to the cell style and 20% accent 6. 20% accent 6 cell style to this one. The next thing to do is bold the values in the range A6 up to A10. So we are supposed to bold the values in the range A6 up to A10. So first we will select this range and we are supposed to bold these values. Now we are going to do next part, that is part D. Prepare the counting number format with 0 decimal places and the dollar sign as a symbol to the range B6 up to F10. So let me select this range first. And we are supposed to apply the counting number format with 0 decimal places. So decimal places should be 0 and symbol should be the dollar sign. Click OK. You can see that counting number has been applied to this range. Now let's do the last part of step 6, that is part E. Resize the column width of column B to F to 12. So first we will select the column B to F and then we are supposed to change the column width to 12 points. Do not ungroup the worksheet. So that is all about step number 6. So we have completed 6 steps of this assignment. And now we are going to do next step, that is step number 7. I am doing this assignment step by step for you so that you can solve this assignment on your own. So with the Idaho, Montana, and the that's step number 7. With the Idaho, Montana, and Oregon worksheet still grouped, update the worksheet as follows. In cell A6, change the text in percent to read walk up. A6. So A6 is here, and we are supposed to change the text in person to read walk-up. So we are supposed to make this as walk-up. So we will change this to walk-up now. In cell A9, change the text other to read other reference. A9 is other, and we are supposed to make it other reference. Do not ungroup the worksheet. So we are done with step number 7 as well. So that is all about step number 7. And now we are supposed to do next step, that is step number 8. So with the home Tana and the Oregon worksheet still group, create a formula as follows. Enter a formula in cell B10 using the sum function that totals the sales for quarter 1. So now we are supposed to enter a formula in cell B10 using the sum function that totals the sales for the quarter 1. So let me go to cell B10 and we are supposed to sum these value for the quarter 1 in cell B10. So we are supposed to use a sum function here. So type equal sign and look for sum function. Then we will select this range for quarter 1, B6 up to B9, and we will get the result for quarter 1. So we got the result for quarter 1. Then next thing to do is copy the formula to the range C10 up to E10. Ungroup the worksheet and then check to confirm the formatting and the formulas from step 6 to 8 are present in all three worksheets. Okay. So now we are supposed to copy this formula up to E10 and we will get the quarter 2 total result, quarter 3 total sales result, and quarter 4 total sales result. So now we are supposed to ungroup these worksheets, and now we will check that these formatting have been applied to these two worksheets as well. And you can see that the formatting has been applied to other two worksheet as well. So that is all about step number 8. So basically, out of 16 steps, I have solved 8 steps for you. That is 50% of this total assignment. Now I will match the result for these steps with the figure. And how? So let me check the how worksheet, and you can see that our results are exactly matching to this figure. And Montana. And our results are exactly matching to this one as well. Then the last one is this one. And you can see that results are matching. So I have solved 8 steps out of the 15 steps. That is 50% of this total assignment. But if you want me to do this complete assignment for you, my WhatsApp number and email is given. You can contact me either through WhatsApp or email. And you can ask me to do this assignment for you. You can ask me to do this complete course for you. Thank you so much for watching my video. I will get back to you in another video. But if you want me to do this assignment or this course for you, you can contact me through WhatsApp or email. Thank you so much.